Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to customize the individual views of the Blazor Scheduler. Before proceeding further, let me first explain you the wide variety of Blazor Scheduler view modes like 5 calendar and timeline views and 2 agenda views. Now, I am going to show you how to set different views in the Blazor Scheduler. For that, first, let me open the existing Blazor application, where I have added a Blazor scheduler with remote data. Suppose, if you want to know how to bind remote data to Blazor scheduler, then you can refer to this video link shown in the above YouTube card. Here, I have set the property bind selected date as June 2017, because the appointments retrieved from this service are in this month. Along with this, I also define t-value with the appropriate value to specify scheduler data source type. Also, I have set scheduler height as 600 pixel. Now, let me run this application to show you the output of this example. When you look at the output, you can see the default views of the scheduler, such as day, week, work week, month, and agenda. In case if you want to display specific views in the scheduler, then I may need to use schedule views tag. Now, I have planned to show calendar views in the scheduler. To display specific views, first I need to define the schedule views tag, which accepts one or more schedule view tags within it. Here, I have planned to load 5 specific views, so let me define 5 schedule view tags. Then, within the schedule view tags, I will add the property option and set appropriate values to them. Look at the scheduler now, the layout simply displaying the calendar views, where the day view loaded with a single day, the week view loading 7 days, the work week view loading 5 working days, the month view loading a single month, and the year view loading 12 months of a year. Notice here, the appointments are differentiated with a circular dot below the date of the calendar in the year view. Similar to these vertical views, the Blazor scheduler also supports to display all these 5 views in horizontal timeline mode, which are referred to as timeline views. These views show all its appointments horizontally, as the scheduler time slots are displayed horizontally. Now, I will show you how to display timeline views in the scheduler. To display the timeline views within the schedule views tag, I simply need to define 5 more schedule view tags and add the property option to them. Then, I will set the appropriate values for those option properties. When you look at the output, you can see the timeline views like timeline day, timeline week, timeline work week, timeline month, and timeline year shown in the scheduler. By default, the timeline year view orientation is set to horizontal view. In case if I want to change the orientation as vertical, then within the schedule code, let me define the property orientation and set its value as vertical. Look at the scheduler now, the timeline year view displayed in the vertical orientation. Here, by default, months in the timeline year view displayed from January to December. Suppose if I want to customize the first month of the year in this timeline year view, then I can make use of the property first month of year, which is applicable only in the timeline year view. To customize the first month in the timeline year view, I need to define the property first month of year within this schedule code. Here, this first month of year property accepts integer value. Now, I have planned to display the first month of the year as April. So, let me set this property value as 4. See the timeline year view, the first month of the year is April in the scheduler. Apart from these calendar views and timeline views, there are agenda and month agenda views to view appointments in a list-like structure. So now, let me proceed to show you how to add agenda views to the scheduler. To display agenda views, first I need to add 2 more schedule view tags and define option property to them. Then, for these option properties, I will set the values as agenda and month agenda to it. To have better clarity in the output, let me remove all these timeline views and their properties from the scheduler. And now, you can see the scheduler, the agenda views are displayed, and the appointments are listed one after the other like this. In this month agenda view, You can see the calendar displaying at the top, and if I click on any particular date, then the events of that selected date will be shown. As I mentioned in my previous video, by default, Scheduler loads week view as its current view. Suppose if I want to load month view as current view in the scheduler. Then, within the schedule code, I need to define bind current view property and set appropriate value to it. So here, you can see the scheduler displaying month view as its current view. Okay, next let me show you how to customize each individual view with different options. First, I will show you another option for changing the current view. Now, I have planned to load year view as current view. So, I will define isSelected property and set its value as true within this year view. So that, the scheduler will load the year view at its initial load, even though the current view property is set in the scheduler. Look at the scheduler now, displaying the year view as its current view. Okay, the next important configuration on the scheduler is to extend the interval of views. Say for example, if I want to display 3 days in the scheduler, then I need to set its interval option as 3 within this day view. And now, you can see the day view displaying 3 days in the scheduler. Similarly, if I want to display 2 weeks on the scheduler, then I need to set the interval option to 2 within this week view. So here, you can see the scheduler displaying 2 weeks when you switch to the week view. Alright, finally I will show you how to change the view labels over here. To change the view's label, I need to define the display name option and assign a valid string to it. Now, you can see the label displaying 3 days, and when you click on it, it'll show 3 days on the scheduler. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points we have discussed in this video. We have seen the different types of views available in the Blazor scheduler. Also, we have discussed how to work with each scheduler view's unique configurations. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link, which is shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting a free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community guidelines. So check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, if you find this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.